traffic authorities looking into the possibility a senator was on board a vehicle that sped off after being caught using the EDSA bus lane this morning. Job Manahan tells us more.
A vehicle that has a number 7 protocol license plate eluded traffic authorities on Thursday morning after initially being apprehended for using the EDSA busway along the part of EDSA Mandaluyong. The Special Action and Intelligence Committee for Transportation, or SAIC, stopped the black SUV that was tailing 2 police cars that were also apprehended for using the busway. When the driver provided his driver's license to SAIC operatives, however, he started his engine and left the scene. Based on guidelines from the Department of Transportation, only senators could be issued protocol plates with a number 7.
Naibigay na daw yung lisensya at kukunin sana yung ORCR pero tumakbo na. At ang nagulat ng mga SAIC operatives. Lahat na tinanong ko pero hindi nila ma-identify kung sinong senator yung nakabasat ang pagkakasabi. Oo, may sakay. May pasahero yung driver.
Gizmundo added that what the driver did was considered a disregard to traffic rules and regulations. He may face stiffer penalties. The DOTR said it is already looking into the matter and they have no news yet whether or not there was really a senator on board. What was clear though was the presence of a passenger based on a statement of a traffic personnel.
Titingnan pa nga ano yung mga applicable na sanctions, penalties. Dahil nga sinuway niya yung paggamit ng busway, which is alam na natin yung kung sino lang ang pinapayagan dyan. So malalaman natin kung ano pa ang edad sa disregarding traffic rules. Tinitinan na, alam ko kasi pagka ganyan tinakbuhan mo, mas malaki ang penalty niya ipapataw sa'yo. Pero definite, within the day ay maglalabas ang LTO ng show cause order dun sa driver.
In November 2023, the MMDA limited the use of the bus lane to government officials, which only includes the President, Vice President, Senate President, House Speaker, and the Chief Justice. Just recently, the convoy of Narvacan Mayor Chavit Singson was caught using the EDSA bus lane. Meanwhile, a couple of vehicles with stickers of the Philippine National Police were also apprehended for using the busway. Among them was a police personnel who declined to be interviewed. SAIC also stopped a van with a PNP sticker. The drivers said they were on the way for an emergency at Camp Krame. Operatives, however, allowed one PNP vehicle carrying personnel from the Explosive Ordnance Disposal and K-9 Group due to an ongoing operation at the QCPD Station 2.
Bali, paneling po kami sa may Station 2. Operation paneling.
The violations committed by government officials and police personnel come as President Marcos called on them to set an example by following road rules. The Transportation Department again reminds all motorists not to use the exclusive busway unless they fall under its guidelines. It said only ambulances with patients, police with ongoing operations, fire trucks responding to fire incidents, and select Philippine officials could use the EDSA busway. Job Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Vice President Marcos has issued an executive order regulating the use of protocol license plates. Pia Gutierrez joins us with the details. Hi, Pia.
Yes, Sandy. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has signed an order regulating the issuance of low-numbered protocol license plates to government officials. Executive Order No. 56, signed by Marcos Jr. last March 25, authorizes the assignment and issuance of low-numbered protocol license plates to vehicles used by government officials. The order actually amends the previous EO No. 400, which had included regional trial court judges in the list of authorized government officials who can use protocol plates. And with the order standing, the protocol license plates are now from 1 to 12 and then 14 from the previous list. This means that the number 16 protocol plates, which were used to be given to RTC judges, are now removed. So the designation are as follows. President will be issued Protocol license plate number 1, Vice President is 2, Senate President is 3, Speaker of the House of Representatives is 4, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court is 5, Cabinet Secretaries are 6, Senators are 7, Members of the House of Representatives are 8, Associate Justices of the Supreme Court, the Presiding Justice of the Court of Tax Court of Appeals, the Court of Tax Appeals, the Sandigan Bayan, and the Solicitor General is Protocol plate number 10, Chairpersons of Constitutional Commissions and the Ombudsman is 11, the Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Chief of the Philippine National Police are 14. The EO also states that protocol license plates issued to authorized officials will be valid only during their incumbency and may only be used for motor vehicles duly registered in their name and are officially assigned to them. So the order comes following increasing complaints regarding the proliferation and unauthorized use of protocol license plates, threatening public safety and undermining the integrity of the vehicle registration. The President Sani has also issued Administrative Order Number 18, which prohibits government officials and personnel from using sirens, blinkers, and other similar signaling or flashing devices. In issuing the order, the President noted the rampant, unauthorized, and indiscriminate use of sirens, blinkers, and other similar signaling or flashing devices, which has caused traffic disruptions and unsafe road and traffic environment. The EO states that the unauthorized and improper use of these devices by government officials and employees shall be dealt with in accordance with applicable laws, rules, and regulations. But exempted from the order are members of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, the National Bureau of Investigation, the Philippine National Police, fire trucks, hospital ambulances, and other emergency vehicles. But government officials and personnel are reminded that the use of sirens, dome lights, blinkers, and other similar devices shall only be under emergency circumstances or situations or to ensure the expedient and safe passage of emergency responders. Sandy?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Pia Gutierrez.